In this particular lecture, let us see metabolism of glucose. Now, when a single glucose molecule enters into the cell, what happens to that glucose? Now, all of you know the role of glucose. Glucose is used as a source of carbon and energy. Yes, and here, when a single molecule enters into the cell, that glucose was catabolized by the cell. Now, what type of catabolism is there, or how glucose molecule is used as an energy in respiratory or in aerobic organisms? So let us see catabolism of glucose in case of aerobic organisms, those which require the oxygen. Now, what happens when this single glucose molecule enters into the cell? That glucose molecules, first of all, passes through the TCS EMP cycle. Or it is also called as glycolysis. It is the most widely used glucose catabolic pathway. This glucose is converted to two molecules of pyruvic acid, which at the same time, there is formation of 8 ATP molecules. Then this pyruvic acid further enters into the TCA cycle, and it is finally converted to the water molecule and carbon dioxide. And here there is generation about 38 ATP molecule. So in all, during the glucose catabolism, while converting this glucose to simple water and carbon dioxide, there is formation about 38 ATP molecules. So that is an example, that is the way of glucose catabolism in case of the respiratory organism. That happens in case of respiratory organisms which are aerobic. Now, along with the EMP pathway in the cell also consists of other glucose catabolic pathway, that is HMP is there. HMP is another way of glucose catabolism. PPP pathway is there. ED pathway is there. And our EMP is also there. EMP is most widely used pathway. हा मात्र जास्त वापरला गेलेला पाथवे. So in this particular lecture, let us see the EMP pathway. What is EMP? EMP stands for Emden Meyerhoff. These are the person who discover this pathway. Emden Meyerhoff Parnas pathway. It was most widely used pathway. Widely used pathway and observed in all aerobic as well as anaerobic organism. Aerobic as well as anaerobic organism. Now, what is this EMP pathway, or what is this glycolysis? Say, बघणार आहे आपण आज glycolysis. So, what happened when a single molecule of glucose enters into the cell? When this single molecule of glucose enters into the cell, that glucose was phosphorylated with the help of one phosphate. It was taken from ATP. ATP donates its phosphate to glucose at its 6 carbon atom. ATP is converted to the ADP, and the product form is glucose 6 phosphate. So a phosphate gets added from ATP to glucose to form glucose 6 phosphate, and the enzyme which catalyzes this reaction is hexokinase enzyme. As there is phosphorylation, the name of enzyme is kinase, and as it acts on the hexo sugar, the enzyme is named as a hexokinase. There is formation of glucose 6 phosphate as a first intermediate, which is further converted into its isomer, and the isomer is fructose 1,6 diphosphate. So there is formation of fructose 1,6 diphosphate. This reaction is isomerization reaction governed by enzyme glucose 6 phosphoisomerase. So phosphoglucoisomerase, as the reaction is isomerization, the name of enzyme is phosphoglucoisomerase. After isomerization of glucose 6 phosphate to fructose 6 phosphate, this fructose 6 phosphate undergoes phosphorylation. A phosphate from ATP was given to the fructose 1,6 phosphate, and ATP is converted to the ADP, and the product form is fructose one seeks diphosphate. So it is a key intermediate of the glycolytic pathway. The enzyme which catalyzes this reaction is phosphofructokinase. Phosphofructokinase. Again, it is the kinase enzyme because that governs the transfer of phosphate from ATP to fructose 1,6 diphosphate. After the formation of fructose 1,6 diphosphate, this fructose 1,6 diphosphate split up into two intermediate. One is glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate. There is splitting of 6 carbon atom sugar into 3 carbon atom sugar to glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Dihydroxyacetone phosphate, which can be abbreviated as PGAL. Glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate can be abbreviated as PGAL, and dihydroxyacetone phosphate is DHAP, and the enzyme which governs the reaction is aldolase. So this is the splitting of 6 carbon fructose to 3 carbon compounds like glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. This glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate can be converted into the dihydroxyacetone phosphate, or dihydroxyacetone phosphate can be converted into glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate by the enzyme isomerase. Here, rate of conversion of this dihydroxyacetone phosphate is more as compared to the glyceraldehyde to dihydroxyacetone phosphate. So all this dihydroxyacetone phosphate is converted to glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate, and this glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate then enters into the further glycolysis. Here, this glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate undergoes oxidative dehydrogenation. A hydrogen molecule from this glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate was removed. It was accepted by NAD, and NAD accept that hydrogen pair. NAD is converted to NADH2. In the presence of inorganic phosphate, this glyceraldehyde donates its hydrogen pair to NAD. NAD is converted to NADH2, and the product form is 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid. Glycerate hone apan. The 1,3-diphosphoglycerate, and the this reaction was catalyzed by the enzyme. The name of enzyme is glyceraldehyde 3 phosphodehydrogenase, or you can say it as a glucophosphodehydrogenase. That is the name of enzyme which govern the dehydrogenation. Glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate undergoes dehydrogenation. Hydrogen pair was removed. It was accepted by NAD. NAD is converted to the NADH2. So this is the intermediate form. This 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid then converted into the 3-phosphoglyceric acid by donating its phosphate to ADP, and ADP is converted to the ATP. So from this reaction number 1, reaction number 2, reaction number 3, these three reactions are called as preparatory phase of the glycolysis. It is called as preparatory phase because in these three reactions, there is use of ATP from the cell, And further all reactions are called as the payoff phases. They are called as payoff phase because here ATP was generated, ATP was synthesized. So these are the payoff phases of glycolysis. So this 3-PGA, 3-phosphoglyceric acid is formed by taking one phosphate. It was given to the ADP. ADP is converted to the ATP. And the name of enzyme which govern this reaction is phosphoglycerokinase. That is the name of enzyme. After formation of 3-phosphoglyceric acid, it is again converted to the 2-phosphoglyceric acid by the enzyme isomerase. This reaction is isomerization. Again, the name of enzyme is phosphoglycerokinase. isomerase, that is the name of enzyme. Then formation of 2-phosphoglyceric acid again donates one phosphate. Donate one hydrogen pair. It releases one water molecule to form the phosphoenol pyruvic acid. And the reaction was governed by enzyme called enolase. So 2-phosphoglyceric acid is converted to phosphoenol pyruvic acid by liberating one water molecule, and the product form is phosphoenol pyruvic acid, and this phosphoenol pyruvic acid is finally converted to the pyruvic acid. This pyruvic acid is formed by this phosphate from phosphoenol pyruvic acid is converted to the pyruvic acid by liberating one phosphate. That phosphate was given to ADP. ADP is converted to the ATP, and the final product of glycolysis is your pyruvic acid. It is a key intermediate. Here, this final reaction was governed by enzyme pyruvate kinase. That is the name of enzyme. So these are the different reactions of the glycolysis. Let us give the numbering to that reaction. First reaction is glucose 6-phosphate to glucose to glucose 6-phosphate. That is our first reaction. Glucose 6-phosphate to fructose 1,6-diphosphate. That is our second reaction. Fructose 1,6-diphosphate to fructose 6-phosphate to fructose 1,6-diphosphate is the second reaction. Glucose 6-phosphate to fructose 6-phosphate, fructose 6-phosphate to fructose 1,6-diphosphate, and this reaction, split reaction, is the fourth reaction. Isomerization is the fifth reaction, where there is formation of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and DHAP, that is dehydroxyacetone phosphate. Then next intermediate is 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid. Glyceric acid. This is reaction sixth reaction. Number of reaction is sixth reaction. 1,3-diphosphoglyceric acid to 3-PGA. It is your seventh reaction. Then 2-PGA, eighth reaction. Then dehydrogenation, removal of one water molecule is the ninth reaction. And last reaction is the formation of pyruvic acid. So that is how there are 10 different steps during the glycolysis. And among these 10, first 4 stages are called as the preparatory phase of the glycolysis. And next further reaction is the payoff phase of the glycolysis. Now let us see the net gain of the ATP, net gain of ATP in case of glycolysis. As I told, one ATP was used here, minus 1 ATP. 1 ATP cells have upper lagile. So here the 1 ATP was minus. Then in reaction number 3, again 1 ATP was taken from the cell. So here there are 2 ATPs from the cell are utilized. Then next is from this split reaction, it is a splitting hote, there is formation of 2 intermediates, which are interconvertible. He dogune ekmekat interconvert hotat. So from this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, there are 2 intermediates. Dehydroxyacetone phosphate is converted to the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So everything will be double. He saga tumcha double asnare. So during the 6th reaction, NADH2 is produced. 6th reaction la NADH2 produce hoto. From NADH2 we get the 3 AT molecules. So reaction number 6 gives the 2 NADH2 is equal to 6 ATP. So here we get the 6 ATP, because when this NADH2 passes over the electron transport chain, there is formation of 3 ATP molecules. So from 2 NADH2, it has a reaction double at tumcha. Current dehydroxyacetone phosphate, it tumcha. इकडे कन्वर्ट होणार आहे, डिहायड्रॉक्सॅसिटोन फॉस्फेट इकडे कन्वर्ट होणार आहे, त्यामुळे इथून पुढे सगळं डबल असेल. ग्लिसेरॉल डी एड थ्री फॉस्फेट पासून सगळं डबल आहे, त्यामुळे तुम्हाला एनएडीएच टू डबल मिळेल, 6 एटीपी मिळतील. देन ड्युरिंग द रिएक्शन नंबर 7 यू गेट द 2 एटीपी मॉलिक्युल प्लस 2 एटीपी मॉलिक्युल. ड्युरिंग द रिएक्शन नंबर 10 अगेन वी गेट द रिएक्शन नंबर 10 वी गेट द 2 एटीपी मॉलिक्युल. सो दॅट इज द इन दॅट इज द सिंथेसिस ऑफ एटीपी ड्युरिंग द पे ऑफ फेजेस. नाउ व्हॉट हॅपन्स, दिस 2 एटीपी ऑफ द सेल should be given to the cell. So for this 2 ATP, these 2 ATP are given, and the remaining 6 plus 2 is the 8 ATP is the net gain of glycolysis during, net gain of ATP during the glycolysis. So this is in short about the first step of the glucose catabolism, and that is EMP pathway. Yes, in next lecture we will see the फर्दर स्टेप ऑफ द ग्लुकोज कॅटाबॉलिझम, दॅट इज TCA सायकल. पुढच्या रिएक्शनला आपल्याला ही TCA सायकल स्टडी करायची. वी हॅव स्टडीड द EMP पाथवे इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर लेक्चर. सो हियर वी स्टॉप द लेक्चर अँड देन इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी सी द TCA सायकल.